The Bible is clear. You know, all we have to do to cause Satan to head in the other direction, it's real simple. One word. You know what it is? One word. Resist. That's it. That's all that's required. According to post-resurrection scripture, the only thing the person has to do in order to cause the devil to flee is simply this: resist. If you will resist the devil, he will flee from you. That's it. That's called free will choice. All I have to do is say, no, no. And the moment I do that, he has to flee. He has no choice. That's his mandate. But we make it a battle. We make it a big, big struggle and battle. Oh, we got to, in the name of Jesus, I command you, blah, blah. Oh, I will never leave. It belongs to me. Back and forth, back and forth. Wait a minute. All the guy has to do is say, you know what? I don't want this to happen anymore. No. Gets quiet. Why? Because that's what has to happen. And so when a person manifested a demon, I just go, hey, what do you want to see happen here? It's your choice. Oh, the devil's making me do it. No, he's not. Mm-hmm. It's your choice. But if they would get honest, but I need them to, because I don't want to go to that memory. And as long as I got a demonic spirit manifesting, I don't have to remember. I don't have to feel. I don't have to do. Okay, now we're getting closer to the truth.
Right. In resisting, there's a gradient. It's not just like, no, 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 no. It's just, if I have no reason or no purpose for him to meet for me, then that's resisting. Yeah. I mean, resisting can just be, yeah. It doesn't have to be this giant struggle.
Right, right, right.
But if I have reason or purpose for the demonic manifestation, then am I resisting it? Well, no.
I'm encouraging it.
Yeah. I'm inviting it. I'm asking for it. Now, consciously, am I? Well, probably not. But on a belief level, I am. It's meeting a need. It's solving something, right? And so the problem there is not the demons. It's not even the fact that I'm not resisting. The problem is what I believe. Because once I know the truth, I will resist effortlessly, and he will flee. Mm-hmm. But I don't have to try to resist in order for him to peel off, because then even if I do that, I still believe the lie, which is my real problem. If anything, the devil was helping me point it out. Right? If I'm not ignorant of his schemes, if I know his purpose, if I know how easily manipulated he is, as soon as he sees a lie in my life, he goes up and touches it every single time.
Yeah.
Well, isn't that good? Because now when he touches it, I feel pain, and now I'm able to get to it even quicker.
You don't have a victim sitting in that chair. Therefore, they don't need you to rescue them. But the demons are manifesting. Well, then ask the person what he wants to see happen there. Do you want demons to manifest? Well, no. Well, then don't do it. Because they don't have to do it. They don't make you let them do that. Mm-hmm. It's all belief and choice. Right. It really is, folks. And you say, well, I don't know. Well, go home and try it. Next time demonic spirit manifests in a session, get the person's attention and ask them questions like this first. Well, just say, you know what? Hey, Mary, let me ask you something. Do you believe something happened at the cross 2,000 years ago that put Satan in a different place than he is today? Well, yeah, what happened? Well, he was defeated. Okay, so you believe Satan was defeated? Yes, I do. Do you believe that Satan can make you sin? Well, of course not. Well, then can he make you do anything else? I guess not. So then, he can't make you do something you don't choose to do. That's right. Well, then don't manifest. Don't let him manifest anymore, because it doesn't have to happen. Now, you can say it nicer than I just said it, but that's my point. But see, we got caught up in this thing is that somehow a demonic spirit manifests, oh, we have a victim we need to rescue.
Right.
No, you don't. You got a demonic spirit manifesting, but it's only because it's operating within the parameters of that person's will. They're allowing it. It doesn't have to happen. But Ed, there's a demon there. So? The only reason he's there is because of the lie. When the lie is identified, the Lord gives him that person truth, the demon will be gone. Mm-hmm. And you don't have to do anything. It will just be gone. It's only there because of. And it's actually serving a purpose. It really is a solution. Now, the person may not realize it's their solution until they're challenged to let it go. And it's like, well, I don't know about that. Because it serves a purpose. Like I said before, Satan's primary strategy is to provide you with a solution. Because if you will buy in on his solution, it keeps you in bondage. Because it means the lie gets to stay in place.
Right.
And that's all he's interested in, is keep you deceived. And he wants to keep you deceived and provide you solutions to deal with the pain. And then after you do your solution, he comes back and condemns you for the solution. You stupid Christian, you can't even keep from drinking. You're always drinking, drinking, drinking. And then your pain stirs up and he goes, well, I think you should just take a drink. So you take a drink. Oh, you're worthless, no good, you're always drinking. And then you feel bad about that. Then he comes back and says, well, here, you know, I just get it. And around and around and around and around. Providing a solution. Then condemning you for doing what he suggested that you do. Well, Paul said, Satan no longer takes advantage of us because we are not ignorant of his schemes. There's your answer. Truth. Mm-hmm. When you know the truth, everything gets quiet. Matter of fact, you know what? The only power Satan has over you is simply the lies you believe. That's it. And when he sends a message into your mind, the only reason it has impact is because you believe it.
Right.
If you didn't believe what he just told you, it would have no impact. But it's because you believe it that it has impact. So what's the answer again? Truth. I've told this story before, and I'm gonna truncate it and really reduce it down just to make the point here. I was in Africa some years ago, and a pastor had asked me to come to his church because they had some demonized people that were, they couldn't cast the demons out of, and they were struggling with this, and the pastor heard my presentation and what we're talking about here. He said, would you come to my church and just do what you're talking about? Because we've got these people in our church that we have been trying and trying, and every time we approach them, they become violent, and they scream, and they yell, and they fall on the ground, and it takes three of us to hold them down, and we're doing the best we can, but we can't seem to drive the devil out. I said, sure, I'll be happy to do that. So he takes me over there, and he brings this lady into the room. And when she sits down in the chair, you can see she's ready to go. I mean, she's just ready to pounce, you know. And I said, ma'am, before we start, I need you to look at me. She says, and she just kind of stares, glares at me. I said, do you believe that something happened 2,000 years ago that put Satan in a different place than he is today? She said, yes, he was defeated. I said, okay, so we agree on that? Yes. I said, okay, let me ask you something. Do you think the devil wants you to sin? Oh, yes, of course he wants me to sin. I said, can he make you sin? And she said, I suppose not. I said, so he can't make you sin? She goes, no, he can't make me sin. I choose to sin. I said, okay, so if the very thing he would want you to do, he can't make you do, what can he make you do? She said, well, I don't suppose he could make me do anything. I said, okay, so then do you want him to manifest through you during this session today? She said, well, of course not. I said, well, then don't do it. Okay. And we did a beautiful session together, went to some really terrible, painful memories, and the Lord spoke truth to her. Not one time did we have any demonic manifestation. It never showed up at all because she simply decided not to do it. Mm-hmm. That's all she did. Now, we hadn't even got to the lie. She just simply said, okay, it's not going to happen. Well, good. Now let's deal with what we need to deal with here. And the lady had a wonderful session. The Lord showed up, gave her truth. And then at the end of the session, I said, I want you to close your eyes, go back inside, look around real hard, and I want you to find those demons I was told about early on. And so she's sitting there, and after a little while, she opened her eyes up, and you have to go to Ghana to understand what I'm going to say to you, but God has blessed those people with the biggest beautiful smile, the set of teeth you've ever seen. They are all teeth, and when they smile, it just makes you kind of back up, because they have bright, white, big mouth teeth, and all of a sudden she opens her eyes, and all of a sudden, whoa, here comes a smile, you know, and she goes, they're gone. And I said, are you sure? She goes, they're gone. And I said, that's post-resurrection deliverance. You don't have to deal with the devil. He's already been dealt with. Now all we got to do is simply take ownership, identify the lies, and let the Holy Spirit give us his truth. That's where God wants us, on this side of the cross. Something happened 2,000 years ago, very significant. We say it, but then we do something else.